Inner Traditions Audio presents Slavic Witchcraft, Old World Conjuring Spells and Folklore by Natasha Helvin. Read by Robin Douglas. Introduction. Sorcery as a living tradition. Storms make trees take deeper roots. Dolly Parton. Russian sorcery is based on the interventions of gods, spirits, and forces of nature in the lives of common people, as well as the ability to control these forces. I can say with certainty that Russians have used sorcery to achieve their goals for many centuries. Magic was an integral part of pagan traditions practiced by our ancestors, and that magic had as its aim help in life, healing, and freedom from negative energy. Our ancestors used magic of all kinds, from spells and charms to incantations for luck in business and battles. Russian sorcery is a synthesis of paganism and Christianity. There are still people who celebrate pagan festivals and conjure on Christian holy days. There are still witches who whisper upon tied knots to curse or heal. Sorcerers are capable of some truly extraordinary things. I was born in the Soviet state and lived there until I was 18 years old. As a child, I saw my grandmother and mother use magic in their everyday lives to help neighbors, friends, and others seeking help. I am a fifth-generation hereditary witch on both my maternal and paternal sides. In my family, we never separated magic from everyday life. My mother, sister, and I held a séance to contact the deceased when I was 7 years old. We read tarot cards to see if we would pass a school test or if a boy I liked would ask me on a date. Every quote-unquote Christian holiday was a great time for me and my sister, as we performed many divinations in a way that was fun, playful, and appropriate for our ages. We called on the spirits of the dead in so many different ways, and it was just a part of our fun time with family. I learned from my family the ancient secrets of magic and healing and the boundless potential of the human spirit, and I inherited my passion for magic and fortune-telling from them. From this long line of metaphysicians and rich spiritual cultural heritage, the roots of occultism and conscious thinking rapidly developed in me at a very young age. What we believe in is the ability to change the world by starting from within yourself. We believe that you can bring forth peace by first learning to love and appreciate yourself and your ancestors. We believe that rules are not arbitrary, but instead made by you in accordance with your own beliefs. We believe in free will, and we believe in magic and the power that it holds. We adhere to the wisdom of our own voices because we know the greatest gift in the universe is free will. Ultimate and omnipotent, bound only by love and ameliorated by the practice of magic. Each of us is an epicenter of self-empowerment because we make our own rules rather than wishing for a non-existent guidebook to life. You don't need the permission of a self-help guru to go out and conquer the world. You have all the potential that you need within you to take charge of your life, to learn the fundamentals of true powers of conjuring, and to love without condition or expectation of reciprocity. We embrace free thought and celebrate the forbidden as part of our spiritual independence. My childhood and teenage years were fulfilled by magic. Magic was everywhere in the air, in everything we did, in the way my parents spoke and acted on a daily basis. For us, it wasn't magic. For us, it was the way we lived, and we didn't know anything else, so it was normal. From the time I left my birthplace until now, every single day, I miss that kind of magic in the air. Living without magic is like returning from vacation to work you dislike, going back to the routine and, for most people, the normal way of life. What made me write this book? If I can say it in one word, nostalgia. Nostalgia for real freedom, the one found in magic, not the artificially presented one. I wanted to share and show people that there is another life out there in the rural areas of my country, and I'm sure many other countries as well, where there are still believers in the old ways and people who live their life freely, free from the dogma, rules, and grime of the modern world. In this book, I will explain the secrets of the profound system of thoughts and practices that underlie the East Slavic culture. Both the spiritual heritage of ancient beliefs and the practical steps that we can take to help ourselves in our daily lives are presented in this book. I begin by explaining the relationship between Christianity and paganism in Russia, as I know it from my parents, grandparents, and the community around us. The foundation of our upbringing there is magic. In bedtime stories, movies, and literature, at school, folklore, in magical proverbs, and more. The core message is that you can do and achieve anything if you believe in yourself. I will also give some background on Slavic magic, what it is, why it works, and some folklore about sorcerers that persists to this day. Next are several chapters on spells. These spells are mostly from my family. Some spells were collected from different people while I was traveling abroad and going on expeditions to rural areas of Russia. The spells are divided into the categories of love and relationships, money, wealth and business, protection, house and home, health and healing, and dreams and divinations. Cemeteries are their own special magic, and I have included a chapter on cemetery traditions, folklore, and spells. The book concludes with Slavic magic tips for all occasions. Chapter 1. Pagan Christianity or Christian Paganism. Russians brought Christianity and paganism together to the extent that it is difficult to say which one has prevailed. Christianity accepted within itself the pagan origins, or paganism, which swallowed up the Christian dogma. Cardinal Elie de Talleyrand Périgord, 14th century, in one of his letters to Pope John XXII. In Russia, Christianity and paganism constantly struggled with each other to dominate the popular consciousness. But in an odd way, these two belief systems also complemented each other. The baptism of Russia happened forcefully. In fact, there were three separate attempts to convert Russia to Christianity, and they all failed. People didn't want to accept a new faith that was significantly different from paganism, and with good reason. Authorities were trying to manipulate the most sacred and intimate thing a person has, his faith. Christian saints began to replace pagan gods. But the old gods were always there, hiding underneath. This led to the creation of a unique, quote-unquote, dual faith phenomenon that still persists. There is no reason to categorize the mixture as good or bad. Its existence simply shows the originality and uniqueness of Russian culture. To this day, every part of our lives is infused with the remnants of paganism, even though more than 1,000 years have passed. That's how persistent a religion can be. Beliefs of the Old Faith. Old believers, or original believers, refer to people who lived in the time of the ancient Slavs. It was a huge tribe that inhabited not only the contemporary territory of the old believers of Russia, Ukraine, and Belarus, but also of the Balkans and Baltic states. They worshiped the old gods and brought them rich offerings in return for peace and a good harvest. The ancient Slavs performed the rites that formed the basis of today's elemental and natural magic. The four elements represented pure nature for all old believers. It was nature that fortified their magic and combined the strength of all the elements at once. Earth. Mother, protector. She gave food, clothes, and the ability to sow and harvest crops. Water, without which there would be no crops. A human cannot live without water.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.